Welcome to writecool.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to write scenario for login page. While writing a scenario for login page, as you can see here, either you have to go to the sign in into the portal, and once you click on the sign in, you will find it out the login page will appear. So sometimes what happens whenever we are doing the sign in, there is a structure like we have username fields. Then either we can enter email address or mobile number, or we have to enter particular username. Then after that, we have to write password. And here you can see several options are there, like click on checkbox to remember me, or stay sign in, or forget my username, create an account, or several buttons are there. So while writing these type of scenarios, you have to keep in mind that coverage of test scenarios will be perfect, so that whenever the execution team will perform the execution activity, they will cover the complete test cases or complete scenario for that particular page, so that we can see that execution is completed as per required documents or as per BID documents. So we'll see here how to write scenario for the login page. So please be available from start to end of this tutorial. And if you are visiting this channel first time, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for latest update. So whenever I will upload a new video, it will get notified to you. Now, for writing this type of scenario, let's take a screenshot of this page and paste it to our Excel sheet, so that that will be easy for us to write the scenario. So here I'm just pasting it so that this page will be in front of me. And now here I will write down the name or scenario number or test case ID. I can see scenario ID, then name. So don't be confused here. We are not writing the test cases. We are just drafting the scenario, so that it will be easy for us to divide into test cases. So I'm giving here as a number SR001 2, and this is third one. Now, first is logo. Either you can start with the logo. So let's begin with the order. So here we have to verify the logo first on login page. To verify logo, so here we are covering, instead of logo, we have to just write in some descriptive manner, like color, size, and actual logo. So we are verifying all three types, like we are verifying the color. So the color, whatever is defined for the Yahoo, that should be present. Size of logo should be as per the size mentioned. Then in actual, so if you want to see the size of this logo, we have to navigate it to the, just press on F12 or just click on inspect. Over it, you will find the size of that logo. You can see here height and width is 27. So this is how you will verify the size is perfect or not, because this play a very important role. In similar way, let's, if I want to verify the size of this logo, you will see here, just click on inspect and click on this, and you will find it out logo with their size that will be defined in CSS. This is how you can identify where you will get the size. Now we have covered this one. Second is text, sign in text and sign in using this account. To verify sign in text, the text should be clear and within the center align. So alignment, we are verifying font, size, style, and alignment. So we are verifying. If you want to divide the scenario into test cases, there will be three test cases for this one. There will be three test cases for this one. Next is to verify the username field or username text box. So sometimes what happens on login page, this text will appear inside this text box. Otherwise, sometimes they are keeping as label. So this text is appearing on label. Hence, I am just writing to verify username label. So this username label should also check the style of the font, style, size, and alignment. So whatever alignment is provided, that should be as per the BRD document or business requirement document. Now we are jumping into to verify text box, username field, or we can see that text box. Now here, so whenever we are verifying any text boxes, keep in mind for verification of text boxes, there are several rules are defined. So if you will follow these rules, you will never miss any scenario and your coverage of your test case or scenario will be complete. No one will say that your test case scenario is incomplete, and by using that, we won't be able to test everything from this page. So first is to verify the length. So while verifying the length, how many characters we can enter the input. So characters, initially you can start with the length. So length, if we are verifying length, so how many maximum character it will accept. So length, it means max and minimum, both max and min. So here this will create a two test case for length. Maximum length, how many characters will enter it in terms of input, then minimum length. Now second field is type. So which type of value we will enter it. So while entering the username, either we will use alphanumeric. Alphanumeric, it means this will be a combination of alphabets and numeric. So like this, write Gurukul 1, 2, 3, this will become alphanumeric. So here we are verifying the type. So if type is specified alphanumeric in the validation guide or in the validation sheet provided by the BRE document, that should contain alphanumeric. Sometimes these text boxes will be only numeric. So numeric, it means only 1, 2, 3 will appear here. If they are specifying or their requirement is as per only alphabets, so it means alphabets, right, Gurukul. So this is how we can define the type. So based on the validation rule guide, we have to verify the type of input. Type of input. Next is, now here we have covered type of input, which, so here there will be three test cases for it, one positive and two negative, right? Then special character. So how many special characters are allowed or not? Then we have to verify non-printable character, if non-printable characters are available or not, or if we can enter it. So based on the validation rule, we have to verify this one. And finally, when we are entering the detail, that should have in order, or that should have the order, because we are doing here login validations. So that should match with the exact value, whatever we are using. So if you are using valid username, so by using that valid username, person will be able to enter into the login screen or into the main screen. So here we are doing with valid credential. If I am entering wrong combination of invalid credentials, then we have to write invalid credentials as well. Correct. So for doing this login page, let's create a scenario. So here I'm just writing to verify with valid username and password. So this is my positive scenario. So by entering valid username and password, the person or the whoever who is doing the login, they will be able to enter into the main page. Now next with to verify with invalid username and valid password. So in this scenario, the person won't be able to log in. Next is exactly reverse of this one, valid username and invalid password. And third scenario will be both are invalid. So invalid username and invalid password. So except one, these three members won't be able to log in it. Now, scenario covers the validation only. We have to verify the maximum length and minimum length in the input criteria. So for the testing point of view, this is the mandatory requirement to verify these many fields at the time of register page. So here, let's create a scenario for username and then we'll create it for the password. Let's mail it for to verify username field length which will be minimum and maximum. So this will cover both the fields. Now next is type. So based on the type of input which is defined, if it is alphanumeric, numeric, I am giving AP alphanumeric, numeric, or only alphabets. So this will become second type. Then which all special characters are allowed? Now here I am defining special character like dollar, then ASCII, percentage key, or exclamation key. These all are special character. So with special character, I am removing this. Which all special characters are allowed? Then if some of the login page are not taking non-printable character, then definitely they will not consider it at the time of creating username. So here username field with non-printable character. Next will be here we have covered everything now. So these four will be for valid. Now we have verified input text, right? Copy the exactly same thing and made the changes for password. Password. Copy this. Now it's done. Next one is sometimes we have multiple buttons. Right now we have a next or submit button. So write down for submit button. So to verify submit button, sometimes we have reset and clear button as well. So whenever the user will enter valid username and password, that person will be able to enter into that screen or see the email, right? Now we have done with this. Now here we have to write down state signed in. So if we are to verify state signed in, checkbox ticked. Here we are verifying stay signed in checkbox is. If this text box, checkbox is ticked, in that case, what happened? Whenever we are doing the login next time, or we are just entering that URL next time, that will navigate directly into our login page. If we are not checking that, it will never enter into the login page. It will ask for the username and password again. So here, without checkbox text. So we are writing both the cases. Forget a username, and we are creating, clicking on forget a username and password, that will again open a new window where it will ask your email ID or username, and that will trigger an email message to your forget mail or password to reset your password. So here I'm just writing to verify forget username. Now we are done. Here, if you want to create an account, we have to write click create an account, so that will navigate into the register account page. And now if you have Google email ID, we can also write on the test case. Apart of that, sometimes we have footer section as well. So if you can see here in ryagurukul.com, here this is a main header sections on menu options. Sometimes in login page we have footer sections where the social media icons will be available, and copyright sections is also there. For writing this type of test cases, we have to write the copyright message. So let's cover that as well. To verify copyright message, now we have covered the copyright message as well. Apart of that, we can also write to verify social media icon. So whenever any person will click on that social media icon, it will navigate into the page where they will see their main or actual page if they are already logged in into their social media account. To verify social media page. So this is how we will write the exact cases. So whenever you're writing the text box in, and always keep in mind, this will always be appear in some time. Sometimes what happened, a few of the organizations are entering the few of the organizations are keeping validations in password. So, or security check in password. So minimum length or maximum length for the password. So these all fields will be there, or sometimes they want specific combination of that password so that the user will be more secured. So in that case, we have to cover that credentials as well. So this is how we'll write the scenario for login page. Hope you like the content. If you think so, we can also add some more scenarios. Please add into the comment section, so that will be useful for the other user who is watching this video. And please be subscribed to this channel, so whenever I will upload a new content, that will be trigger a notification for you for early watch of the content. Thank you for watching.